Hi everybody, happy Halloween and welcome to the Halloween Treats Tag. This is an original tag by Megan's Reading Revelations. I'll leave a link to her channel and her video down below. And the reason I'm doing this is because I saw Dom over at Dominish Books do this. I didn't get tagged, but I decided I actually really want to do this because it's Halloween themed and these are some really fun prompts. So yeah, I've just decided to do it, but I'll leave a link to his video down below as well. He's a fantastic channel you should definitely check out. But yeah, these are some really fun prompts that are about different types of Halloween sweets, and then you just respond with the book according to the prompts. So without any further ado, let's get into it. Number one is Gummy Bears, a book where the characters have to get out of a sticky situation. Now I'm actually going to be quite literal with that one, and that is going to go for The Starless Sea by Erin Morgenstern. Now without getting into spoilers, there's a certain scene, I'm fairly sure I remember this right, where a character has to literally get out of a sticky situation. If you've read the book and you know, you know. Number two is Milky Way Midnight, a book that kept you up reading through the night. And that actually hasn't happened to me for a while. I did actually, The Starless Sea, I could answer that with that again, but I'm not going to. The last time I remember staying up quite late to read a book was when I was doing a reread of the Truly Devious series. Now I'd read Truly Devious and The Vanishing Stair, and The Hand on the Wall, the third book, had just come out. And I remember rereading The Vanishing Stair up until about 1 o'clock in the morning or something, because I just couldn't put it down, even though I knew what happened. And then, or not even 1 o'clock in the morning, it must have been just before midnight, because then I realised that I had a free trial of Amazon Prime and could order The Hand on the Wall and it arrived the next day so I could continue reading the series. And yeah, that's the last time I remember reading that. Really, really great series as well. I still haven't read this fourth book. I'm really curious to see what's going to go on in here, but yeah, great series, and that's the last time I was up quite late reading a book. Three is Caramel Apple Lollipops, your favourite middle grade or children's book. And I haven't read middle grade for quite a while. I keep accidentally calling some of my books middle grade, but they're actually just quite on the younger side of YA. But I think I'm going to have to go for Dragon Rider by Cornelia Funk. This is one I haven't read for a long time, but I do remember really, really loving this book, and I think it's middle grade. And yeah, really, really great book that I read a lot when I was in school, because our school had a copy of it in the library. And it was one that actually my sister read that then I ended up reading as well. Really, really enjoyable, and it's one I actually really want to reread and see if it holds up. Four, Reese's Pieces, a book that's short but packs a punch. I've actually got a couple of options for this. The first one is Empress of Salt and Fortune by Nevo. This was really great. Like, it's a short novella that I actually listened to on audiobook, so it was only a couple of hours long, and it's honestly fantastic. I absolutely loved that book and just the way, the format of it. I think one thing I really like novellas is that authors almost become far more creative as to what the story's about and how they're telling it, because it's such a short, you know, time span in the narrative. Well, not even in the narrative, but they don't have much time to tell their story. So this is between two characters, one of whom is telling the story of how she was the maidservant to the Empress and the things that happened over the years to this cleric who is taking note of these stories, because that's what the clerics do, is they record history, they record stories. And slowly through these, like, just anecdotes of her daily life and things that happened between her and the Empress, you uncover this bigger story about what happened with this Empress when she was alive, and just a much larger story in amongst all these smaller moments of between these two characters. Really, really great book, and I absolutely love it. Number five is Milk Duds, a book that disappointed you. Sadly, this is a recent read for me, and that is Descendants of the First by Rennie K. Amayo. I really liked Daughters of Enri when I first read it, and then I reread it earlier this month, and it didn't quite hold up, because now I've kind of got my reviewer hat on, so I can kind of pick up on, you know, certain things that kind of bothered me. But, you know, the pacing was really good, and the characters had a lot of potential from that first book, and a lot of the things were very much just, oh, this is an author's debut book, I'm sure they'll get better. And immediately a lot of things I did have a problem with in that book were resolved in Descendants of the First, like point of view changes within a paragraph, basically, you know, she stopped doing that. And the writing has gotten a lot better, but the characters are incredibly flat and they're all the same, and I don't really give a shit about any of them, and it's such a shame, because you're supposed to believe in these romances and this love triangle that they've got going on, and this friendship and this sisterhood, and it's just not there. There's just no depth to these characters, there's no reason, they just don't feel like real people, which I think is such a shame, because this is evidently supposed to be a very character driven story, and it's just missing that depth of these characters. The pacing as well of this one was just a bit off. Like, I found it really, really very difficult to get to finish this, despite the fact it's not too big of a book. I just really struggled with this one. The pacing wasn't quite there, and the characters, unfortunately, are still just incredibly flat, which for me is a bit of a turn off. And I was very upset because I've actually been really anticipating this one. Number six is Snickers, a book that you devoured, and this is one I read immediately after Descendants of the First, and the contrast between, you know, it took me about 3 weeks to read Descendants of the First, and I finished this one in about a day, and then I only had about basically one sitting, and then I had 100 pages to make up the next day. That's Iron Widow by Zhiran J. Zhao. This is another one that was highly anticipated for me. You know, I'd watched the author's YouTube videos, I'd heard the hype when the cover got released, like, obviously I was going to buy it. And then when the arcs got sent out, everyone was raving about it. I love this so much. As I said, I read this whole thing in basically one go, bar 100 pages. It's just so fun and really interesting. It's a really fun blend of sci-fi and, like, you know, big mech piloted thingies, I can't even remember how to describe them, plus Chinese history, like, it's amazing. I really, really enjoy it. It's very well written. It's very, very fast paced. I almost would prefer if it slowed down a little bit and we got a bit more downtime with the characters, because I kind of wanted to see a bit more of the characters, especially interacting, particularly relationships wise, but I still think it's absolutely great, and especially very, very good for a debut novel as well. I'm very excited to see the rest of this series, but yeah, devoured this and I already want to reread it. Number seven is Peppermint Patty, a book that is refreshing, and for me I'm going with And the Ocean Was Our Sky by Patrick Ness. Patrick Ness is one of my favourite authors and I always describe his work as refreshingly weird, and The Ocean Was Our Sky is no different. This is the tale of Moby Dick, but flipped, where it's the whales who are kind of hunting down this character who's evidently supposed to be a human. That's like, you know, the evil human instead of the evil whale, and this sort of human character kind of becomes their captive and stuff, and you're following Bathsheba, the whale, and how she's kind of interacting with this human and stuff, and they're trying to come to terms with the sort of animosity between humans and whales. It's so weird because the centre of gravity is like at the point where the ocean meets the sky, so when you're in the ocean, you know, down is towards the surface and up is towards the seabed, and then when you get to the surface things flip and suddenly everything's down and the human world now is above you. It's really weird concept, and there's some really interesting pages in here where that gets illustrated by the illustrator on how the centre of gravity then kind of flips from one to the other. It's such a bizarre concept and I absolutely love it, and this is just such a great book as well. Like, the illustrations, as I've shown you, they are just gorgeous, and it's just such a great book, and I highly recommend it if you haven't read it. Number eight is Dark Chocolate, a book with a good romance, and for that I'm going with Harley in the Sky by Kenny Dawn Bowman. This is a YA contemporary sort of story about a girl who runs off to join the circus and starts up a bit of a romance with one of the other circus members. And I love the romances in a Kenny Dawn Bowman's books. They're always just so sweet and gentle and just really cute to read, and this one's no different. They have a bit of a shared kind of, they almost starts off with that kind of like quietly enjoying each other's company, which I love, and then it just kind of blossoms into something else, and I just absolutely love it. It's just such a good book, such a cute romance, and I can say that about all the romances in her stories. Like, I always love them. One of my all-time favorite authors, one of my all-time favorite books. Number nine is Peanut Butter Taffy, a special edition book you own, and I don't actually have too many special edition books, so this is actually the only one I've got here as well, and that is my copy of A Darker Shade of Magic by V.E. Schwab. This is the collector's edition. Now, it says exclusive, but I'm fairly sure these were, like, you know, loads of people have these, and it's quite different from the book to begin with. It's black instead of white with this on the cover, you know, obviously you can see that's gold, and then you've got this, take the dust jacket off, and you've got the wee gold sort of imprint, you've got the map in there, and then on the inside of the dust jacket you've got all this official art and stuff, which I really like, and the dust jacket itself is just really, really pretty. I love these covers, and yeah, it's a really, really cool edition. I actually really want to reread Darker Shade of Magic, because I read it back in college and I loved it so much I did a project on it, and yeah, I really, really want to reread it, because especially since she's continuing the series, I'm really curious to see kind of where that's all going to go. But yeah, this is one of my like favourite little copies that I've got. And finally, number 10 is Tag Some Friends. So I've picked out a few people who want to do this. Obviously, as usual, there's no pressure to do this. Other than that, this is a Halloween tag and I'm planning to post this on Halloween, so feel free to like save this for next year if you want to, if you don't want to be too late for it. So first person I'm going to go for is Josie Hillsdale. She is a fairly new booktuber who has a variety of books that she reads and really, really great videos. I absolutely love her channel. If you haven't checked her out already, you definitely should. So I'm tagging her. I'm also going to be tagging Owen Edwards because he's tagged me stuff before. I need to revenge tag him, and I have nothing nice to say about his channel. And finally, I'm going to tag Lawrence from Reading with Lawrence. She seems to quite like sort of spooky books and stuff, so I think she's quite into Halloween, so I think she'll enjoy this tag. She's a really great channel if you haven't checked out hers. Similar thing to Josie, she reads a lot of different types of books. She reads thrillers and romances and fantasy and YA and stuff, and does really, really interesting videos. She does blogs and wrap-ups and reviews and things. She's a really fantastic channel. If you haven't checked her out, you definitely should. All the information for the people that I tag will be down below in the comments, will be down below in the description. And yeah, definitely go check out all three of their channels. But yeah, happy Halloween. I hope you have a really great time today. And let me know, what is your favourite Halloween sweet? Why? And what are your answers to some of these prompts? Have you read any of the books that I've mentioned? Let me know down below in the comments. I would love to hear from you. Feel free to like this video and feel free to subscribe. I'm trying to post a couple of videos every week. But thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time.